a very sentimental person.
This has been a real deep podcast.
I didn't mean it to be so. The death of Stalin.
That was not funny.
Oh!
It's the traditional hero arc. You want to see the struggle?
There's no heroes here.
No.
And I still think to this day that they probably are still, you know, thrusting around in the dark.
Oh, no,
so
I think,
to speak.
I think, no, don't.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry about that. I hit the wrong buttons. This is Paul in Considered and Conceited. And as you know, last week Pip went down to Melbourne and had a procedure. And I have to announce with a profound amount of grief that she's made a full recovery. How are you, Pip?
Wow. You were going with that.
Oh dear.
Oh my gosh.
It was either that. I was thinking about intro for this week because each week you come at it and you like, I give my intros a bit of thought nowadays because I have to because you keep trying to snipe them all the time.
I don't do anything.
Yes, you do.
Oh, geez.
That's fine.
You make it sound like I've had something awful done.
Every time. Every time.
Oh, Paul.
Yes, every time.
No.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Carry on.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for the podcast pick of the week. Thank you.
You are such a wanker.
Why, thank you, Pip.
Oh, wow.
Is that with capital W?
Exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark.
Okay, well, this week's pick of the week, Pip.
Podcast pick of the week, Paul.
What did I write down?
You mean, what did you ask me to write down?
That's the one, yes.
I've got written here, popcorn psychology.
Popcorn psychology. Okay, now, popcorn psychology, blah, blah, blah.
Popcorn. Go again. You can do it.
Popcorn Psychology is a podcast that is it tickles my fancy quite a lot in some curious ways. It's you give me some odd looks there, Pip.
Don't worry.
It tickles my fancy. I didn't say I'm like over in the corner having full masturbational rights there.
Darn it! You didn't have to take it the full.
Well, no, you were. Look, I was being subtle, and you were carrying on. So. Fuck it.
Anyway, what do you like about this podcast? What is this podcast about and what do you like about it?
Well, I like it because it takes apart films like the Harry Potters and things like that, and it does the psychology thing much in the same way as Capes on the Couch. In fact, they are linked. They've done a couple of crossovers themselves, each of these, and there's basically three psychologists, and they obviously enjoy just talking shit about movies and things like that, you know, around the water cooler when they're not working. And what I think has happened is that they have decided, well, let's do a podcast and actually do this properly.
And just record ourselves talking around the water cooler.
And it's fascinating stuff. It really is. It's very easy to listen to, I find. I don't know if it's necessarily to everybody's liking, but when it comes down to psychology and why we are the way we are and what makes us tick, I can't get enough of that stuff. I probably would have been a psychologist in a previous life or something, I imagine, you know? Because, you know, I have all the subtlety, all the subtlety of a psychologist, you know.
I think you just like the idea of going, you're crazy, you're crazy, you're crazy.
That would be judgmental, and yeah. I think that that's a bad thing, Pip.
Oh, sorry. It sounds really interesting, and I saw a couple of the ones that they've done. I haven't listened to any of them yet. It's on my list.
Yep.
And I thought, ooh, that sounds really interesting because they've done The Last Jedi. They've done Captain America.
If you enjoy Capes on the Couch or have tried Capes on the Couch and you enjoy it,
I like Cats on the Couch.
This is a very easy transition.
Okay, yep. I'll have to have a listen.
I'd start out with the Harry Potters.
Yeah, because they've got two episodes. They've got the 1 to 4, and then
the ones the later years,
6 to 7. Yes, or whatever it was. Yes. I saw
and,
as well.
And it's very easy listening. And,
okay,
and they do some other stuff. And I'm not saying you have to, you know, plow through each and every single one. But if there's movies that you like that you're interested in, listening to this is kind of a little bit like listening to the writers actually pulling apart their characters and saying, well, this is why I think that this character did such and such sort of thing.
Okay.
So,
sounds
so
good.
Popcorn psychology.
Excellent.
It's worth an investigation.
And it's not political.
Well, I just thought... Thank you, Pip.
Couldn't help myself.
No, sorry. Sorry, we were having another one of those conversations in the kitchen.
A D&M.
Before we started. Yep.
Was it more a political and deep and political?
Once you shed the kids, you can actually hear yourself talk, can't you?
Oh, yeah. Yep. Sorry about that today.
All good.
Anyway.
All right. Okay, our first movie.
So, hang on.
Yes.
So, these are the last three movies that were nominated for Best Film Academy Awards.
These are the last ones. And at the end of it, we can do a big roundup, if mm-hmm. you like. And we can, you know, I think there's a couple of interesting ones in this week. So, we'll find out about them.
But these three movies are the last lot of the ones that were nominated.
And then we'll match them all up against Green Book and see if any of them knock him off the post.
Or that you think, yeah.
Well, it's our opinion.
Oh, it's only our opinion.
That's the only
thing that matters here.
It's the only thing that matters here.
Anyway, so...
We don't get considered by conceited by proxy. You know? We go in boots and all.
Nice. All right. So, first one is Black Panther.
Just excuse me for a sec. I'm just going to adjust myself. Oh, that's better. Okay.
Was it uncomfortable?
I couldn't see the name properly, and you can hear it's already a lot
better. That sounds much better.
Thank you. See, I did need adjusting myself.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Right. Well, the first one is...
Marvel's Black Panther.
Okay. Excellent. Pip, could I have a synopsis, please?
After the death of his father, T'Challa returns home to Wakanda to take on the mantle of Black Panther and King. When a powerful enemy from Wakanda's past reappears, T'Challa fights for his own beliefs, his people's safeties, and that of the whole world.
Thank you, Pip. That was very well read.
Thanks.
Oh, well, it was. It sounded quite epic.
Did it? Yes. I wrote it very, very quickly while there were three screaming children today.
Yes, well, the screaming kids, it's all good. Okay, I'll turn that off now. We don't need drums beating in the background. What do you think?
Oh, well, I've got a soft spot for the Marvel superhero films. So I really like them. I love the whole, you know, superhero thing and, you know, people fighting for people who need it and...
Yep.
You know, helping the innocent.
Sure.
You know, doing the right thing, even when you could do the wrong thing. And
two-dimensional characters and everything.
You know what? Sometimes it's nice to have that. Sometimes it's nice to have someone just go, I just want to do the right thing and help others.
That's why I like Tony Stark. He's quite complex. And
oh, yeah.
Yes, and he sometimes drifts a little off-centre.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah. Whereas in Captain America, for example.
Oh, you know exactly what you're getting.
That's right. Even though... He went a little rogue in Civil War.
Oh, but he was doing it for the right reasons.
Was he?
Well, that's what
he thought so.
Mm.
He thought so. Now, I think that this is probably the most un-Marvel of all the Marvel films.
It says a lot, which is unusual for a Marvel film.
Yes.
It's funny in that
and
regard.
Consequently, I find it a little bit more satisfying in not against all of them, because some of them are sensational. It's not my favourite Marvel film. I have to... Can I say what my favourite one is?
Go for your life.
Ragnarok. It's just... No, Thor just cracks me up. I just love it.
It's a comedy, really. It's lovely.
It is. And like...
Taika Waititi does a great job.
You wouldn't think that Thor is such a... you know, a comedic
I think it's done really well. It's so different. You want a bit of difference. Yes. I mean, and the good thing about this film also is that little bit of difference.
Yes, and that's right.
And I mean, some people get upset with it, but others go, oh, I love the fact that there's so much now that I can enjoy. Yep. Out of them. Well, yep. If they were all exactly the same, you'd get bored.
You would. And that's... Sorry, we're just looking at our son. He's
our son.
My son, then, if you like.
Not mine. Don't push that on me.
He's dressing up as Iron Man Hulkbuster. There you go.
Oh, right. Is that why the head's fatter?
That's why the head is fatter.
Oh, wow.
It's a fat head.
No, I'm just thinking.
And so's the costume.
Iron Man's been squashed. His head's all fat. But no, I just realised it's the Hulkbuster.
Okay, come on. Focus here.
I'm trying.
It's Black Panther here we're talking about, not Hulk. Now I've started recording.
You've sorted out the Hulkbuster.
With the voice of God.
No, Black Panther I found really interesting because, you know, they're not touching on too many subjects, but they're just sliding them all into sort of not force people to think about it, but they're available there if people want to, you know, hop out of the hero world and actually go, well, hang on, these are relevant issues. And, you know, for instance, there's lots of very strong female roles in this.
There are.
And they're awesome.
They are.
I mean...
Your favourite?
I like Shuri and Nakia and... Oh, okay. She's the general. She's awesome.
The Amazon general with the neck rings.
Well, she's not Amazon. She's African.
No, but I mean the Amazonian style, you know, female warrior.
Oh, yeah, classic. No. She's awesome.
She's dressed like a classic Amazon.
Yeah, you know what I mean? She's very cool.
She is extremely cool and funny. And extremely funny because she's the one, she's the straight man in the whole lot of that.
Mm.
And everybody else is just a little bit daggy. And she's trying to hold the whole lot of them together. And you can see that she's got her own sense of humor. And I think it comes seeping out through the edges very nicely. I like it. I think her character's excellent and well thought out.
I think they're all, it just works out really well. And they're just so strong and funny. And normally a lot of the comedic stuff is given to male roles, which is, I have nothing against. But
why
this,
is that, Pip?
Well, because I'm happy for everyone to have a go.
No, but why do you think that comic roles are given to men? Is it just part of the patriarchy or is it that men are funnier than women?
I don't know. Some men are funnier than women. Some women are funny. Than men. I mean, just it depends. What are you smiling at me like that for?
Oh, I was just going fishing, that's all.
What I'm saying is I thought having like Shuri and the general having all these really interesting comedic sections were really – I just really enjoyed that for me.
Yep.
I love that switch around.
The special effects were –
Oh yeah, this sand, the black sand stuff was pretty cool, wasn't
Loved
it?
Loved that. That was very clever because it's not often you see something very new and original and like a brand new concept, and that was all done very well. I thought
it was done really well. It's the whole thing's been really thought out really well.
And their little holograms where they hold it in their hand, and you know they've got the little person in the cup of their hand.
But they're all little balls.
Yes,
and you just touch it and suddenly whoosh.
Very clever. Very clever.
And it looked great.
But, the big combat at the end.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess it's a typical Marvel big combat at the end sort of thing.
Well, they've
got
to have one, don't
but
they?
But they had a lovely, like, what I liked about it was a slightly different storyline in that, you know, he does well, he gets going, and then the other guy, the bad guy, rocks up, usurps the
Killmonger.
Crown. Yep, that's the guy. He rocks up and usurps it, and then they had to go to their political enemies for support, and that all comes together again. And yeah, it was, look, I just thoroughly enjoyed it all round. I thought it was just well thought out, well paced, very good film. Not my favourite, I have to say, but and you know why it is, although it's a little bit like subtitles in that because the accents are quite distinct sort of thing. It's hard for me to pick out.
And there's subtitles in it anyway.
Words. Yeah, I just, like the communication side of it, I struggle with a little bit. And so it's harder work for me.
Mm.
And I always resent films a little bit when they make me have to work because I'm, inherently lazy.
Mm.
So So, yeah, so, look.
I just like the fact that he's starting to take responsibility for something that, well, he personally didn't do, but that he just decided that his country was, as he being their king, he was going to take